In this video, I'm going to show you my favorite eye contact video editor. This will allow you to read a script on camera, but make it look like you're not reading a script. That's actually what I'm doing right now. I have a text document open on my screen, and I'm reading. My eyes are moving back and forth as I read each line. And then I use the software Veed to automatically edit my eyes so they look directly at the camera. I've been using this software for over a year, and I've only seen a couple of hiccups, and I'll talk about those so you know what to watch out for. And I'll also tell you what I use for eye contact during live video calls. But let's dive into Veed now. Okay, so here's my workspace on Veed. I'm logged in, and you can start this process one of two ways. One is if you're ready to just get going, just record the video here on Veed. The other is if you've already recorded your video and you want to just edit it, but you'll end up in the same exact spot. So let's show you first what the recorded video is. You can choose here what you want to record. Is it your screen and your camera, slides and a camera? So you've got a lot of different options to go through for the recording. But what I'm gonna do is, because I've already recorded the video that you saw just before this, I'm gonna go in here to create a new project. And as I said, once you do that recording in Veed, if that's the way you're doing it, it'll put you back into this exact same video editor. But I'm going to choose to upload the file. I recorded this in ScreenFlow, by the way. It's just a nice software that I'm used to using, but I guess I could have done this in Veed. Okay, so this is what we have here. You can see here that I'm reading and I'm not looking at the camera if you look at my eyes. So this is an important step here. You need to click on the video to be able to see eye contact over here under Magic Tools. And you can see a number of the other tools here, green screen, remove background, magic cut, removing odds, things like that. But we're talking about eye contact in this video. So we're gonna click on that and it's gonna go through and do the processing. It might take, you know, 30 seconds or a couple of minutes depending on how long your video is. Okay, there we go. You can see that it was always on zero. It didn't go zero to 99%. It just jumped forward all the way to 99%. And you can see here how the eyes have been corrected. So let me just turn off eye correction so you can turn it on and off here. There we go. And you can see that it's gone through the entire thing, putting my eyes looking at the camera. Okay, so once you've done that, then you click the Done tool. You can also go through here and do some editing here, changing where it starts, stops, things like that. There's a lot of editing tools here, but we're focused on eye correction in this video. So click the Done button, and then I like to go through here and turn on custom, and you can choose what quality you want, but I like to click on this button here and then choose custom settings of resolution of 1080p, quality of high, and then compression of high quality. So this way you get all of the best settings. Then click export video. And you'll see it's actually going to post it to the Veed website so that you can share it directly from Veed. But what I typically do is I bring this over into something like Final Cut Pro where I can edit it even more and, you know, blur the background and do things like that. So this is just, I'm just using this software for the eye contact correction. And you can see here what it looks like. And you can share it from here. Let me just click on that. You can share it out and it'll host it on the Veed website. But what I want to do is download it. So let's click on download. And then go over here to click on MP4 because I want to download both the audio and the video. And we're going to download it here. And then I can open that in something, as I mentioned, like Final Cut Pro and do the final editing. So let's talk about when this did not work for me. Veed is constantly improving the software, so issues like these are becoming less common. But the first problem I saw was that I recorded someone whose hair would fall in front of their eyes. So let me give this a try. Veed got confused and put their corrected eyes on top of their hair. Very strange. The second thing I've seen is individual frames where the eyes pop up for just one frame floating in space next to the person's head. Also very strange. But as I mentioned, this is not common, but it is something that you should watch out for. Eye contact correction isn't available on the lowest cost plan. It's available on the $25 a month plan. But Veed has a ton of additional tools
like AI avatars and
adding text to the screen as you speak. But for me, the eye contact alone is worth $25 a month. If you decide to give it a try, I'd love it if you use my affiliate link below in the description. And please share this video with others who you think might need to fix their eye correction. And I wanted to mention the tool that I use for live video calls. Unfortunately, Veed only works when editing recorded video. But for live calls, I really love the Eye Contact Pro camera. It allows you to look the other person in the eye on a video call, and they feel like you are looking them in the eye because the camera is actually right by their eyes. I have another video about that you can watch over here.